On September 3, 1942, the world was at war. That was the day my father, Jack Hesser Porter, entered the U.S. Army. He married my mother, Harriet Brown, and they left their home in Hannibal for training in Little Rock. Nineteen years old, from the small town of Frankfort, Missouri, Dad was an only child and a new husband. Together, they moved several times before Dad would eventually be shipped overseas. My dad kept a journal in those early days, writing about some of the national events, new friends he'd met, day-to-day routine. His first entry on February 22, 1943, reads as follows.
Fall in, fall out, fall in, fall out, but today it started. I was made an acting corporal as of today, so I guess I will have to forget the past 6 months of easygoing I've had. Of course, a PFC doesn't amount to a whole lot, but it's by far the best job in the whole Army. The 9th of March, we were sent to Camp McCain, Mississippi, as a rifleman in a rifle platoon. A few of the fellows went to Claiborne, and a few more were sent to Camp Robinson. Not a snowball's chance in hell, but I tried to get transferred to medics, but Captain Donovan wouldn't give me a release. Harriet is home now. Has been for 4 weeks. Seems like 4 months.
By summer of 1944, the division was ready for combat. They sailed for Scotland aboard the Queen Elizabeth. The 94th first traveled from Scotland to England, where they had a few more days of last-minute training. They moved on to the cluttered beaches of northern France and into the lines in Brittany surrounding vital submarine ports. The European winter was bitter. After 4 grueling months, the 94th swept across France, heading into the switch position of the Siegfried Line. They were successful in pushing the Germans back deep into their own border, but the ground was so cold a soldier could hardly dig deeper than 6 inches for his own protection. It was there in Germany on January the 21st that my father was wounded. Soldiers lifted his gurney onto the hood of a jeep and drove him to the nearest evacuation center, where he was sent to Paris and eventually flown to London, where he spent several months of the war. It was during that time that the war in Europe ended. After being released from the hospital in London, my father was sent back to Czechoslovakia, where the 94th was occupying the territory until their release. Scenes like this were commonplace: gypsies, civilians, returning to their homes or what was left of their homes. In this scene, we see civilians digging for bodies. Food was scarce, so when they could, the men went fishing for dinner. My father remembers how grateful many of the local people were and how one family in particular would occasionally cook and invite them in. Here's an article about Bob Hope traveling through Europe. My father was lucky enough to be able to attend one of those. My father doesn't talk much about those days. They are distant memories. Grateful for the war's end, he was anxious to get back home. Nevertheless, there were friends that no doubt saw him through. Finally, in December of 1945, my father boarded a ship destined for New York. December 25th, 1945.
Arrived in New York. Leave for St. Louis Thursday. Wait in St. Louis for me. Tried to telephone. Merry Christmas, my dear. Love, Jack.
My mother was waiting at home. My parents had endured 2 long years.